Big fat content warning on this one for surgery, death, blood, urine, and just general bodily unpleasantness. Thanks.
I'm Hog, this is the Dice, and I'm gonna try take two on this video because the last time I filmed it, it looked terrible. And my delivery was awful. What we're going to be doing is a new segment that I haven't really come up with a name for yet, or at least I haven't settled on a name for yet. I'm thinking of calling it Vlog and Dice. I don't know, maybe. How is it? What do you think? Let me know. Answers in the comments, that would be nice. But what it's going to be is basically me talking about weird shit that has happened in my life or that I have experienced, and by fuck, there's a lot of it. The one I'm going to be starting with, I was kind of reminded of about a week ago when I was unsuccessfully questing for a heart. It reminded me that roughly 15 years ago, around this time of year, I can't remember the exact date, I nearly died. And I thought, you know, that would be a fun story to start with. The time I nearly died, but didn't. So let's go into that. Alright, I was 15 years old, it was coming into summer, I started getting this really bad pain in my stomach. It felt exactly like wind, but just way more severe, like really, really awful, painful wind. It wasn't wind, I was taking like indigestion tablets and shit for like 2 weeks, I couldn't go to school, I wasn't really eating. I was worried it might maybe be constipation, I don't know. I think probably the fact that I couldn't shit was probably more to do with the fact that I didn't eat anything and there was nothing to shit. Who knows? One day, after the 2 weeks out of school, which caused me to miss my summer exams, my pain in my stomach suddenly went from, oh, that's bad, to, oh fuck, I really want to drive my head through this wall right now. And it did it like that, just suddenly, very quickly. So I called my mother, who was at work at the time, and she came back to the house. It took about an hour to get there. And we got in the car, and she took me down the road. There was a doctor who lived nearby, so she brought me to his house. And he was like, I don't know what this is. I don't know at all. So we get back out in the car. My mother takes me to our GP, the general practitioner, the family doctor. And he takes a look at me. And he's like, oh, I don't know. You better go to the hospital. This has taken about an hour. Just this. So we go to the hospital, which takes us another hour. And in the hospital, they're very, very busy. They're overloaded. We've got problems with overcrowding in hospitals in Ireland, I'm not gonna lie. So I'm left on a trolley for a while. And at this point, I've been vomiting on and off, and I'm on a trolley, and I am slipping in and out of consciousness. And I have noticed that it doesn't hurt anymore at all. But yet I can't hold on to consciousness. So I'm like, okay, I see what's happening here. I'm dying, aren't I? Yay. The feeling was actually weirdly relaxing and kind of comforting in a strange way. You'll understand what I mean when it's happening to you. It was a little while, not like an hour or anything. It was like 15-20 minutes before the doctor actually got to see me and looked at me, and there was an examination and x-rays and everything. Doctor's like, your appendix has burst several hours ago. We're very surprised you're not already dead. We're going to cut that shit out of you right now. So they doped me up right then and there, and they cut it out of me, and apparently it was oh, this is the fun bit. Well, a fun bit. Fun. Yes, fun. No. Super fun. No. Lots of fun. No. Super fun. No. They couldn't do the keyhole surgery that a lot of people get because the organ had burst. What they had to do was they had to do the old-fashioned, like, 2.5-inch incision, and they had to go searching through my body cavity for the chunks of what used to be my appendix, and skewer them on a thread, and drag them all out together. Super fun.
No.
I'm not gonna lie, I was a little disappointed by this because it meant that I couldn't take it home in a jar. I kind of wanted to make some kind of, I don't know, like a lamp out of it or something. That would have been really cool. A lamp made out of my own internal organ.
You do not understand me!
I wake up about 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, still doped up to my eyeballs with, you know, sewn up and patched up and everything. I really fucking need to pee. I desperately need to pee. So I get out of the bed and I pull out the IV, which is probably not the best idea, but you know, I did it. And I went wandering looking for a toilet. And this is when I discovered that the hospital in question, which shall remain nameless, had only one toilet per floor. And I don't mean one set of bathrooms, I mean one toilet per floor. So I find the one toilet on my floor, I open the door, and there's this terrified little old lady sitting there. I'm like, oh, I'm sorry, and I leave, and I close the door. But I was high on morphine, so it was more like... So I don't know how she felt about that. I never saw her again. If by some weird crazy happenstance she's watching, I'm sorry. But okay, so I go back to the ward and I look for a bedpan. I'm looking for one of those, you know, metal or plastic kidney-shaped ones. And all I find are these, like, tinfoil, like, takeaway tray kind of ones. Okay, it'll fucking do. So I grab it and I use it, and it's mostly blood. And there's a lot of it, there's an awful lot of it, and this tray is filling up really fast, and it's getting so full it's starting to flop around a little bit and spill just a little bit. So I'm kind of wandering around holding the tray there, looking for another one, and then it fell out of my hand. At this point I was just, fuck it. Just fuck it. Just fuck it! So I just stand there, and I wait until I'm done. Until there's no more blood and urine pouring out of me, and then I get back into bed. And in the morning, the nurse comes in, and the whole floor is covered in piss and blood. And she's like, what the hell happened in here? And I'm just there under the covers like, I don't know. And that's the story of how I nearly died. I really appreciate the fact that my near-death experience is a really funny story. It is so funny. I pissed blood all over a hospital room. That's so funny. I have never told that story and people not laugh except with you. I hated morphine. I hated being on morphine. The disconnect it caused, the total inability for me to keep track of my thoughts in any way. It was not good. It was not good. It was a bad time, and that's why I don't drink and why I don't do any kind of drugs at all, because morphine put me off everything. Morphine made me go, no, anything that has anything remotely like that effect can just fuck off and die in a well. Just die in fucking well. I kind of maybe insisted that I be discharged like a week early. This took a lot of protestation from me, it took a lot of insistence, but I managed to get myself discharged about a week early. when no one was home keeping an eye on me, I went outside and did archery practice with this great big hole in my abdomen. Ba-da-ba-ba-da-ba. Have you nearly died? Actually, yeah. Have any of you had a near-death experience? I actually want to hear about that. And I don't mean it in, like, the usual YouTuber hallelujah fishing for comments kind of way. I actually do want to hear about any near-death experiences you guys may have had. Let's have some kind of near-death club. Like I said, the actual feeling of dying, and I don't mean, like... Like, with a terminal illness or something, it would be very different, because, like, you know you're going to die, but you're not actually in the exact moment of dying. You're not in the, like, I'm actually on my way out. Everything is shutting down at this exact moment. But that feeling where you are in that exact moment where everything is starting to shut down, that is actually almost pleasant. I think it's your brain just releases a shit ton of dopamine and shuts off the pain stuff, because, like, oh, nothing else I can do. Let's just enjoy it. And, you know, that feeling, that kind of, well, it kind of took my fear of death and kind of, like, threw it in a fire. I just haven't really been afraid of it ever since, because... I know, well, that's what it feels like. And that actually felt kind of nice, so...
And I sang death, death, double, 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 evil, 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 evil songs. Hell, you know that's how I get along. The world is full of tragedy, so how can it be wrong? Singing death, 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 devil, devil, evil, evil songs.
Thanks for watching to the end of that discussion of my internal organs. And thanks to Neil McConvera, Mohrak Morvakawas, and Casper Maynard, and all of my other patrons for supporting me and allowing me to continue producing this total fucking nonsense. And thank you if you like or share or comment. That's all really helpful as well. If you want to support the channel, you can do so through Patreon, or you can go to my website, hogandice.com, where I've got books and shit that you can buy, or you can just leave likes, leave comments. They're all useful. It's all great. Thank you very much, everyone. Thank you all. And remember that your applause is the only way to counteract my daily chant of I don't believe in fairies.